Hospital acquired infections is a major problem now all over the world, and we are obviously extremely concerned about it. We have infection control nurses who do daily rounds of all our facility, including the ICUs, the IPCU, and neonatal intensive care. They don't only monitor the infection practices, but hand washing, etc., because hand washing probably remains still one of the most important aspects to try and prevent hospital-acquired infections. Despite all the precautions, hospital-acquired infections are on the increase. The common organisms that we've seen are the Pseudomonas, Acinobacter, and Klebsiella. We try and manage our antibiotic policy very stringently. I have forms which I get various consultants to fill whenever they are using a reserve antibiotic like colistin. Colistin actually came into use in the 1960s and was being used till 1970, but due to the side effects, it was abandoned. It has now re-emerged as one of the major drugs for multi-drug resistant organisms. I hope and pray that this will not be the last line of drug which will be available to us. And therefore, I think the rational use of antibiotics, whether it is in the community or in the hospital, is of utmost importance. But we are already finding, even in this hospital, that where we had the sensitivity of 99% with colistin, it is now down to 90%. Drugs like tigecycline, etc., meropenem, etc., the sensitivity rates are already decreasing at an alarming rate, which are the figures which we have available for our hospital. And it's obviously a matter of great concern to us.